thank you, Andy, and thank everybody for coming out today on another Chicago winter morning. As Andy mentioned, currently I'm consulting for a company called MSR Pharma Services. It's just a shell for my consulting company. I have, my background is about 25 years in the pharmaceutical industry, about 15 with mid to large pharma, and about 5 years with a startup company, and then another 5 years with a contract research organization. My specialty, my training, is in drug disposition and toxicology. And today, I'm going to talk about qualification of impurities, and I'm going to focus on human pharmaceutical drugs. And I'm not going to really get into generics, I'm not going to get into veterinary products or other forms of impurities. I'm going to focus on drug pharmaceuticals. A lot of the basic concepts I'm going to talk about can be applied to the other areas, generic drugs as well as veterinary products. Topics I'm going to cover are the ICH impurity guidance as related to qualification of impurities, safety evaluation of impurities. Also going to give some recommendations on early development. Of course, the ICH guidelines only really focus on marketed products or applications, registration applications. It does not focus on early stage, at least for the most part. So I'm going to give some recommendations there, go over the qualification process. I'm going to spend a good part of the presentation on genotoxic impurities. It's something new. There's draft guidances out there, and I think it's something that we're all struggling with regard to eugenic impurities and how to handle those. These guidelines here basically documents that cover registration applications for qualification of impurities. There are, most of you have heard these and know about these guidelines, Q3 guidelines that cover new drug substances, APIs, it covers new drug products, also residual solvents, and there's draft guidelines now on elemental impurities as well, which is very helpful for the industry. And also, I'm going to focus on the M7, a multidisciplinary ICH guidance, draft guidance that's out on DNA reactive eugenic impurities. Again, I'm not going to cover the ANDAs and veterinary products. The guidances in Q3 emphasize cover synthesized active pharmaceutical ingredients, API. The guidances don't cover, which is important, don't cover some of the larger molecules, semi-synthetic, certainly from fermentation products, but some, again, some of the same principles can be used. There's other guidances out there that cover other types of biotechnology products. I'm not going to really cover those today. I'm going to focus, again, on more of the small molecule synthetic APIs. So the ICH guidelines categorize impurities as organic, inorganic, and residual solvents. They really do not cover some of the other chiral impurities. Again, the Q3s don't cover genotoxic impurities, but they do. There is that draft guidance, which I'll discuss. The organics, of course, are the larger category, if you will, of impurities. They most of the drug-related substances are organic. Obviously, inorganic is also an area that where guidances are out there that are being covered with regard to elemental analysis and the residual solvents. There's new guidance out there, the revised guidance, has been very helpful on setting limits for solvents that are typically used for synthesis of API. I'm going to just kind of go make sure we're all on the same page. This is rather a basic for a lot of you, but I do want to just mention that the impurities can come from a variety of different places along the manufacturing pathway. The starting material, API, is a big source, of course, of impurities. Reagent solvents and catalysts that are used for the synthesis form reactive intermediates and thus byproducts from that reaction. You also have degradation of the final API drug substance. And the degradation, of course, forced degradation, you can help identify some of these potential impurities early on by doing those experiments. The excipient API interactions, and of course the containers that may be storing some of the drug product are also sources of contamination from leaching compactors, for example. The important thing I want to stress in this slide is that the more you have a handle early on your reagents, on your manufacturing process, you can identify potential impurities before they pop up. And this is especially important for genotoxic impurities, because that's something that can occur very low concentrations within the API. So it's very important to understand what are the potential impurities we're going to have into this and really understand your process and the impurities, for example, impurities of the reagents that may end up in the drug substance later on. So that's very important. I just want to stress that.